Successful teaming, and consequently leading, requires that leaders create an environment of psychological safety. What's more is that a crisis demands that psychological safety is created quickly so members can speak up without fear of being embarrassed, rejected, or punished. It's important for a leader to make people feel comfortable being uncomfortable, to respond to social cues, and to engage and empower their team. With that in mind, I want you to think about how you can create psychological safety on the fly. Remember that psychological safety is a team climate characterized by interpersonal trust and mutual respect in which people are comfortable being themselves. Psychological safety is not the same as trust. Trust is about giving others the benefit of the doubt when you take a risk. Psychological safety is the belief that others will give you the benefit of the doubt when you take a risk. Trust occurs between two individuals. Psychological safety is experienced by groups or even your code team. Psychological safety is about honestly admitting your mistakes, giving and taking feedback, and forgetting any privilege or status. We can create psychological safety if we do the following. Be accessible. Invite participation. Acknowledge limits of knowledge. Hold people accountable for transgressions. Set boundaries. Highlight failures as learning opportunities. Use direct language. And be willing to display fallibility. Now, you may be wondering, how does this translate into reality in the heat of the moment? Take a look at these examples of dialogue that facilitate psychological safety. Imagine a conversation in a crisis where team members state, "The situation is over my head. Don't speak to her like that. That's not okay. If I miss this intubation, I'll need you to take over. Jessica, please start chest compressions now. I missed the diagnosis. Let's reset." Or what if we ask, "Are we missing anything? Does anyone have any other suggestions? What can I do for you? What can we learn from that near miss?" Communication style can impact performance and create psychological safety. The take-home message here is that not all communication is created equal. First, the energy and the nature of the communication exchange matters. Saying yes or okay is not the same as facing a team member, using their name with closed-loop communication, and stating directly instructions to enhance psychological safety. For example, "David, I will give a milligram of epinephrine and let you know when it's in." Second, engagement matters and reflects the distribution of energy among team members. A team in which only the event coordinator speaks is not the same as a team in which everyone has a chance to speak and challenging authority is possible. Inviting participation of all team members promotes psychological safety. And third, communication confined to only the team is not the same as exploring outside the team. A psychologically safe team acknowledges the limits of knowledge and is willing to engage with outside members to ask for help. As stated in the beginning of this lecture, when creating psychological safety, it's important to make your team feel comfortable being uncomfortable, to respond to social cues, and to engage and empower your team members to do their best work.